The National Football League participates with the pink gloves and just pink on the players, where if you think football is stupid, you're right. But it's my stupid. You have your stupid. You can judge me in sports. You have your own stupid. You play World of Warcraft or you do Renaissance festivals. You fucking win Brian Doyle Murray look-alike competitions. You grow organic apples and sell them at the farmer's market. You learn how to speak Italian on the Rosetta Stone so one day you can impress your friends by ordering an Italian at a restaurant and the fucking waiter at Olive Garden looks at you going, I don't know what you're saying, dude. Whatever you do, football is my stupid. That's what I do for a few hours on a weekend in the fall to forget how much I hate myself. I don't want to think about breast cancer while I'm watching football to get away from this. It's hard enough to watch football as it is if you're a fan without constantly thinking about AIDS. You have to push that out of your head. Inherently, if you're a fan of the game, with the technology that they have now, you watch Monday Night Football or Super Bowl, they have cameras now that come down on cables right over the field, like right over the players' heads, almost touching them. You have 60 inches of high definition. You have a camera panning around 11 men bent up in a huddle, presenting these beautiful, thick man asses, and it's zooming in on each one, and it creates this Bangkok whorehouse scenario in your brain. You feel a little tuggle in your sweatpants. You're like, oh, what if they were behind glass in Phuket? Which one would I select for my evening's entertainment from the Cambodian guy that runs the place? And he's got an eye patch. And I go, Jing Nai, Gorda! And he pulls the guy out. Number 28. I haven't even seen all the guys. And I impulse buy on 28. He's a halfback with these sinewy horse haunches leaning into me. And in my mind, before I can make a rational decision, I've already leaped over the railing at the field. I'm streaking butt naked across the field, I'm wearing an 1800s nightcap that's striped with a pom-pom. I don't know why that. But I'm wearing flip-flops because they make you run funnier. But my dick is slapping up and down against my belly. You make your dick however big you want it to be. It's your fantasy. Have your dick slap in your chest. Have your dick take a tooth out on the way to the huddle. It doesn't matter. Just get to 28 and yank them out of the huddle and pin them to the ground. Hold them down with one elbow. Peel those. They wear these little lycra pants. They're so fucking gorgeous. And you just peel them off him. He's sweaty. They're just gonna slide off like a wet Band-Aid. Don't fuck with the jock strap. It's no obstacle to the asshole. You're wasting time. Plus, the little straps keep the ass cheek up and focused. Steam comes off his ass. Get your face in there. You huff that steam. You huff it like a gassy rag. Inhale his essence. And you peel those ass cheeks apart with your thumbnails like you're cracking a cage-free, farm-fresh egg. And you take your dick. Don't stab him with it right away. Tease him with it. Here we go. In and up. Asshole to tailbone, people. Asshole to tailbone. Watch him struggle. He knows it's going to happen. He doesn't know when. Asshole to tailbone. Pull on his face mask a bit. Twist his neck. Pull on his dreadlocks. And these are not Occupy Wall Street dreadlocks, by the way. This is a black dude. This is straight up racism. This is a hate crime. Because you are pretty sure that your ex-wife used to fantasize about this guy doing similar shit to her. You know, oh yeah, you want to do that to my wife, you'll never get a thicker boner than that angry, racist, jealousy boner. Veins are coming out of the head, and nothing makes you crazier than when you get that boner, you're just jamming in them like a fat salamander, and you ride, you do that porn angle where you bend your dick down and do deep knee bends so you can look at the people. You have 55,000 people are now out of their chairs on their feet chanting for you. They love you. They're like, fuck that guy. Fuck that guy. This is his home field, and they're on your side all of a sudden. Fuck that dude. Yeah, they're spilling beer. You feel the rubber start to slide off of you, but you don't give a shit. This is my day. They love me. I'm gonna launch rainbows of cum into this broken motherfucker, and you do. You're not even done coming when you pull out. Your dick's just still fire hosing, swaying back and forth, getting rid of the last of the spurts, and you have an end zone celebration dance that you've worked out in the hallway mirror all season. Little old school icky shuffle thing. And you spike the ball right next to his head. He's blubbering like snot bubbles and crying. He's not even making an attempt to get up. His asshole is still dilated. He's spasming. His asshole is winking like a cyclops in a rainstorm. He's trying to regain its original shape. One milky tear is dripping down the taint. It's crying for you. And you float out of this perfect Sunday afternoon and this perfect daydream back into the stark reality of it's just you as some bloated post-middle-aged dude with, you got lumps of yellowed gummy cum in your gut hair. And you look around, you feel immediate remorse and shame. I let the rubber come off inside of that guy. How irresponsible is that, knowing what we know today, to just bareback fuck a guy? I don't know where that guy's been. I know where he's going. He's going into free agency. He's fucking 32 now. He's got shit knees. He's lucky if he's warming a bench in Jacksonville. But I don't know where he's been to just bareback fuck the dude. I could have fantasy AIDS as we speak. And I'm gonna do it again. And as you're dealing with this, you want to escape, you look at the TV, pink shoes, I have to think about breast cancer on top of this problem. You're ruining the integrity of the game, breast cancer. This is what we do on Sundays to forget how much we hate ourselves.